Yeah, so we have a 25 years experienced veteran today, Dr. Shankar Ramamoorthy, Director and Docs Testing. Okay. Dr. Shankar has been a dedicated PPM professional, expert, I can use this word now for him, in software engineering processes, ensuring that efficiency through business-driven quality management system is one of the goals which he has put forward. Software industry has seen his 25 years and he has been working continuously in making the engineering processes more and more effective throughout his life. And I'm very sure that we are going to learn a lot from you on this. Today he is going to talk on DevOps, decoding, DevOps decoding. Okay, so I welcome Dr. Shankar and a big applause for him. So,
DevOps is not new. I knew this 30 years before with a very different name. In fact, it didn't have a name. So then I thought, let me put the whole story in place. And today what I want to do is, I want to share that DevOps, which people are talking about, yes, it's a new buzzword. It is a new buzzword. It is a new way of doing things. That's no doubt. And it's a good way of doing it. But I think we need to understand when to apply it, how to apply it. Every company, every software, every application cannot use DevOps. And I think that is what, when I say decoding the Da Vinci code. Just to give a context, not a history, how many of you have seen this film, the Da Vinci code? Okay, thanks. It's a mystery novel by Dan Brown. And when I personally saw the film, I read the book, I thought that these guys were finding out the clue to the murder. So I'm not saying the software industry has been murdered, not to worry. And they were saying about ways to find out how we can crack the code. It was a storytelling, and I thought, let me also tell a small story to it. And I thought the best way to tell a story today is to use the Panch Tantra. Panch Tantra is an animal fable and a novel which you must have studied, all of you, when you were kids. Yes or no?
Yes.
So when you studied Panch Tantra, the whole story of doing DevOps was explained at every point of time. So I said, fine, let us try to crack this whole Da Vinci code of this murder of York Museum in Paris, where there was a battle. The title of the novel is all about finding the first murder victim. And I'm not going to talk about this because many of you must have gone through the Da Vinci code. I'm not a Mason or any criminal judge or a lawyer, but I thought that the whole business of software development, it's time to crack the Da Vinci code of the whole thinking. So DevOps, when it comes to our mind and thought process, a system thinking comes to our mind. What is a system thinking? Anyone? Any you don't have to define it specifically, any rough definition? When I say a system thinking, what is that which conjures up in your mind immediately?
Seamless execution.
Absolutely, seamless. A delivery system which is seamless. That there is a pipe. I can see the pipe. I can see the delivery pipe. Amplifying of feedback loop, which is one of the pillars of DevOps, and learning the whole process of learning the culture, processes, and technology with a common storyline. So customer requirements are coming at short intervals. We all know that. Business and values have been very much demanding. The customer is demanding than what he was before. All of you agree? From the beginning, customer has been demanding more and more, and his demands gets translated to changes. When the customer demands gets translated to changes, your software engine starts working. 2 hours, 1 hour, automatic deployment, end-to-end, seamless, all this, UAT, and Irfan was right, I think, he was trying to talk about how everything has become within a container, how all applications, your toolset, your environment is all getting contained, and how you're trying to deploy it as simple as self-service application, if I might call. So Rama was right, seamless deployment to production is happening. So the mystery is, how is this all happening? People are saying that Netflix, a company, is doing deployment in 1 hour, in half an hour. Companies are doing deployment in 2 hours. I cracked this code. I found for myself that this is possible only when everything is code. When everything is code, you have cracked the Da Vinci code. And that's the message which I have for today, ladies and gentlemen. The Da Vinci code which we are talking about is nothing but unlocking the DevOps approach. DevOps brought everything on a versionable platform, on a code platform, and code became the beginning and the end. It's like they said, business is all about customer. It starts with customer and ends with customer. I call DevOps starts with code and ends with code. Everything becomes a code, and that's the pure story of DevOps. So let's see the whole story. Gartner himself, the whole team has predicted that by next year, 75% of the large enterprises will go through a bimodal mode, or they will run on two engines. Two engines of economy, of application economy, where one engine will be focusing on stability, and the other engine will be focusing on fluidity. What is stability? Large companies, strong, at the back end, don't need a DevOps. They're happy to be slow. They don't want to be fast. If you make them fast, they will be unproductive and they will fail. Then there are economies which want to be fast, which want to be fluid, which wants to be as faster to the customer in terms of time to market. So I'm seeing two modal systems in IT. a fluid system and a stable system. And that's where I say that we have to run in two engines. The first gear, the second gear, the third gear, and the fourth gear. Now you are told, run the vehicle in fourth gear. That is DevOps. I'm saying there are times when you have to run vehicles which will run only good in first gear. Remove the second and the third gear. If you keep the fourth gear, then they will use it. If you keep the third and the fourth gear, then it's human nature to use it. So DevOps is, everybody is a developer. How many testers are in the room? And how many developers? Okay, yes. So everyone wants to be like you now.
Developer,
okay. You can wear any hat, but everyone say every tester wants to be a developer. Everything is a code, and that's the Da Vinci code in a very lighter form. This discipline is becoming more and more valuable, friends. There was a time when I needed a lot of speed. Today, DevOps has given that speed. No one will debate that you have got a 20% improvement in time to market. Why not do DevOps? You have got a 22% improvement in software quality. Why not do DevOps? You got 17% improvement in frequency of application development, 22% more and 19% increase in revenue. These are some of the figures which tells that DevOps is not a buzzword. It is bound to stay, and don't be fatigued by using these buzzwords. It is bound to stay. Interestingly, how a company looks like. I go to several companies as a part of audit. I say, code commit ho gaya, answer ho gaya, before, version control. Have you done your CI server and orchestration? Yes, sir, I have used Jenkins and Mistro. Have you done the build, Apache Maven and Cradle? Have you done all your tests? Yes, Jasmine, Mockito, Bower, JUnit. I have it. Have you used all the artifacts repository? Well, yes, sure, see my Nexus. See my SonarQ. I have got all the code metrics, better than any metrics. Check mark I got for security testing, and a type for a database. XPI for development, and VMware, which we're talking about, even VMware is getting replaced with this Docker container. They are trying to remove the hypervision, and they're trying to put the Docker engine, and all your builds and the libraries will be connected. We saw that in Infant's presentation. So gentlemen, the whole CI ecosystem, which was just told before by Infant, has challenged the old order. The old order was the global delivery model, onshore, offshore, nearshore, that there will be some people who will have red hats, red energy, blue energy, green energy, developer, tester, caste system. There was a caste system. You agree with me? There was a caste system, and what this DevOps story is trying to say is it's going to break this caste system. It's saying that there is a continuous delivery model. As I'm talking to you, I have made a maturity model in DevOps. 5 levels of maturity model, which I'm trying to patent. At different levels, I know how continuous delivery can be monitored. I call it as a base, semi-base, expert, macro expert, and the giga expert. 5 levels of continuous delivery model. This is a new term which I'm using here. So friends, at the end of the day, every application economy, every business is software business. Can you tell me a business which is not having software component today? It is having a software component. If something is having a software component, then that must have a code, so everything is code, and that's the Da Vinci code. And that's how I'd like to open this whole topic. But I said, I'm going to tell this whole story in the form of a tale, a fable, and I'm going to use the Hindu principle of niti. What is niti? You want to, niti rivaj, what is niti?
Is it destiny?
Yes, very close. It's a conduct of life. There's a good conduct of life. I want to have a good conduct of life, but in the Panchatantra, which the Vishnu Sharma said, how many of you read Panchatantra? Oh, good. There were 3 ignorant princes, the dev, the QA, and the ops. I've converted the princes to the dev, the QA, and the ops. And I'm going to tell the concept of niti, but today I have made a small change. The niti has a sandarb, and sandarb is context. You cannot say that a wise conduct of Irfan is a wise conduct of Aditya. A white element of Aditya is a white element of Rama. Others, I don't know the names. Just I'm taking three examples. I've got my three pillars. Okay. So three ignorant prisoners, not ignorant, on life away. There are several stories in Panchatantra which gets embossed. These embossed stories snap each other to sustain attention of the reader, and then they are epigrammatic verses. And at the end of the day, the Panchatantra will explain you the niti, the good way of doing software, and the sandar, which are the conjoined Siamese twins, best explained as the new developer or a tester is context imperial. He's the king. So who is the king here? The context. There you are operating. It is you are operating in the first year or in the fourth year, you are operating in a stable economy or in a fluid economy. So it is the sandar or the situation or the context which will pronounce itself as a king when you start doing business. And that's what is the Panchatantra which I have tried to map as a corollary. Panchatantra 1, Mitra Veda. What is Mitra Veda? Anyone?
I know I explained it. Mitra is friend and Ved means differences.
Exactly. Mitra means friend, Ved means differences. The story of the lion and the bull, the separation of the friends. The first of the five books of the Panchatantra by Vishnu Sharma says that how friends are together for some time, but for some reason they break up. They said that they have to be identically different. They wanted to establish their own identity. It's like the breaking of the umbilical cord. So the corollary which I'm trying to draw from the first Panchatantra is, they incubated together 30 years before. Senior people in the room like Aditya can appreciate that when in the olden days there was an electronic data processing department. Ye computer ka aadmi hai. I was told like that. This boy has joined you, I was 21 years old. And I was told that this is a computer guy who developed it, test it, code it, he will do everything. So that was how it started. The MIS department of various large government organizations. Now, the Tobolo code was written by me. I tested it, I productionized it, I was a part of the legacy system. It was a closed system, no IVNV, no independent verification and validation. Saugat. Saugat will be able to tell, Saugat from L&T. So there was no TCOE, Saugat, no test center of excellence, no test factory, no managed test. These all we created a lot of money. We made a $60 billion business by first saying that we are together, then we divided. And then we said we are dividing and billing, and then now we are saying we are together. We draw a Venn diagram, development, QA, IT op, and then show the commonality. We are very smart. First we said, don't worry, this work you give me this money, for QA you give me this money, for operations you, everybody made money. Swiss admin made money, QA made money, development made money, all money were created, customer became unhappy, so many people are making money. Customer said, I want to make less money. Don't worry. Don't go away. We have come together. We will give you in less time, less money. This is good. It has to happen. A 360 degree. So the submission of friends, the Mitra Veda, was the need of the hour. The second Panchatantra, Mitra Labha, or Mitra Samprapti. Any guess? Yes, not there, but can you tell? Anybody, it's not a tough word in Hindi. Love is friends. Samprapti means consummation of friends. You're making it. You're gaining friends. Yeah, you get any other examples? Gaining friends?
Adding friends,
simple. You're trying to gain friends through friendship between a rat and a crow, which led her into a turtle and a fawn. And then they all collaborate, ladies and gentlemen, to save each other. And then they said that we are united, united we stand, divided we fall, the friendship happens. This book accounts for nearly 22% of the world's length. So what happened? We all became friends. Tester with the developer, scrum meeting, velocity, burn down chart, stand up meeting, product owners, scrum master, manifesto, Agile came 15 years before, 10 years before. That's a different thing. Agile became waterfall later. and waterfall people said that I have become agile, and then when you go and check their waterfall, that's a different story. I didn't want to go there. But yes, we all said that we are interwoven with the spirits of quality and excellence. This is the Panch Tantra too. You broke and then you became friends. That's the agile. And this is happening in the agile world, that every agile means not about speed. Everybody wants to go without any guidance. It's like running a bike on the road with two hands like this. Okay? Haath chhod ke gaadi chalana. Kuch bhi ho sakta hai, agile. So that's the people have been taking, but no offenses to anybody. This test. The third Panch Tantra is Kapolukyam. Kapolukyam is a war and a peace. It's like the Mahabharata. In Mahabharata, the Pandavas and the Kauravas fought in the morning. In the evening, they used to have food together. In the evening, when Bhishma died, they used to stand in front of Bhishma. They used to be together. There was a feeling of camaraderie spirit. But in the morning, they were wearing a different hat. I am a developer, you are a tester. I am the Brahma, you are the Shiva. Brahma means creator, Shiva means destroyer. So you destroy what? The code. You destroy the product. You somersault the product. You tell this, you challenge the product. That's the job of a tester. The tester started learning scripts. Tester became shift left. What is the shift left? I think somebody will be talking in the two-day program, common terms. What is the shift left? Anyone? Early involvement of tester early in the life cycle. He showed a TDD part. He showed I'll fail it and then I'll pass it and then I'll refactor it. It's a TDD. Fine. Testers becoming pseudo developers, if not full developers. They could at least know how to design. They can know, at least they can write a flow chart. They can do some sort of dynamics out there. So in Kapolukyam there is a tester. There is a developer in a tester, some sort of collaboration has started. That was also a very good beginning. I call it Panch Tantra 3. Panch Tantra 4 is Labh, the profit, the Labh Pranasam. That means the loss of gains. The story of the monkey and the crocodile. You know this story? How many of you know this story? Again, the fourth book talks about a symbiotic relationship between a monkey and a crocodile, which conspires to acquire the heart of the monkey. How the monkey gets to know of this and uses wisdom to avoid the grim fate. So the symbiotic relationship between the dev and the QA started in identification of testers as a separate species. And no one knows when the monkey and a tester and the wisdom. So you have to have that exploratory testing, ad hoc testing, you become a monkey tester. How many of you are monkey testers? Yes? Good. No test case. You are not guided. If you are guided, yes, ad hoc, which you have been doing. And when the wisdom prevails, you can see the loss of gains taking place. So sometimes you are becoming a friend together. At the same time, you are losing your identity. But at the end of the day, a good tester is one who takes pride. How many of you take pride in your job, all testers? How many of you have a complex? Any complexes there, inferiority complex? Developers are higher, I'm lower or something? You should not be there. Because you are now going through a very big transformation where you're going to be jack of all trades and master of? Jack of all trades and master of more than the sum. Okay, so it's a sum game, more than the sum. You are no more a different species. Men are from Mars and women are from Venus. Testers are from Poseidon planet, the 10th planet, and developers are from the first planet which came, which got discovered, which was Jupiter. No. The tester is the most important person in the whole game because a tester can somersault the product. The tester can turn the tables of the product. He can destroy the product, and the most important power which you have is the power of a go or a no-go. Are you using that power? Yeah. You're having the power. The mythology has a power that if it touches that person, the person will become a fire. We may not have the Midas touch. If I touch somebody, I will get gold. But we have the power of Bhasmasura, where I will touch and it will become a fire. So friends, Labha Pranasam, the loss of gain, the monkey and the crocodile story is a symbiotic relationship of the dev and QA, which I mapped. Panchatantra 5, the fifth book, talks about ill-considered action. The action between the Brahmani and the mongoose. This is your cancer defect story. This is your greatest story of defects. The lady said, thought that her child has died, but the child was not dead. She regrets having killed her friend. That is a miscommunication gap is not there. You thought the developer has not. You thought that the tester has, developer has written a bad code. You tested it. The developer canceled it. You fought with the tester. You had a defect review meeting. You fought with the tester. And then you regret, oh, I didn't have the domain knowledge. I wrote a wrong test case. I did a wrong testing. So be careful. Panchatantra 5 is also dangerous. So the message here is to map this whole story of how the IT industry has moved. But the IT industry has moved for success. I call it as the Panchatantra of the success. So DevOps is not a product. DevOps is a methodology, which we all know. DevOps ne kya kiya? It took a Venn diagram of a dev, your IT ops, and your QA, and it broke the silos, which is good for us. It leveraged the people, the process, and the technology, the amplification of feedback loops, the systems thinking, and also the learning and continuous development. The problem with DevOps, the problem with all of us, is that we don't discover the defects until late in the life cycle. Why don't we discover defects until late in the life cycle? Anyone? Though I have the answers and all, you have it on the right, but anyone? Any guess? The response could be wrong. I'm just trying to interact with you. Irfan?
Yeah.
One does not discover software defects until late in the life cycle, even till production. Iska jawab bataiye. I'll ask someone to give the price. Are kuch bhi develop kar do, tester baitha hai. Kar lega. Galti nikalte. The mindset. वो बैठा है बहुत बड़ी टीम बैठी है 100 लोगों का टीम बैठा हुआ है सिस्टम्स केम जेंकिंस केम माइस्ट्रो केम डेवन केम बिल्ड ऑटोमेशन केम एवरीथिंग केम द ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन हैपेंड एंड दिस इज द गार्टनर रिपोर्ट इंडेक्स टू 100 इंप्रूवमेंट ऑफ टाइम टू मार्केट व्हिच इज फ्रॉम 100 लीवर गॉट एलिमिनेटेड वेट टाइम गॉट एलिमिनेटेड and non-value, the waste, the gura, the non-value systems in the assembly line got eliminated. Ladies and gentlemen, we got productivity. Productivity, the real productivity, DO by DI, desired output by design input, not O by I. O by I is a bad way to measure productivity. We got reduction in cycle time. There was a transformation happening because of DevOps. And all the non-value added work items were automated. The major problem in the whole industry is you created automation engineer, performance engineer, manual test engineer. Is it needed? Are performance engineers born with horns? Are automation engineers born with a silver spoon? We said ये बंदा खाली फंक्शन करेगा इसको एक एक ही आदमी क्यों भी सीखता है सिविल सीखता है यू नो ही लर्न्स ऑल द ऑटोमेशन टूल्स एंड अदर्स आर नॉट लर्निंग आई डोंट नो व्हाई दे सेड दैट नो आई डोंट नो कोडिंग बट आई एम बिलीविंग देयर आर गुड टूल्स वेयर यू हैव फ्रेमवर्क्स व्हिच आर स्क्रिप्टलेस देयर आर फ्रेमवर्क्स कमिंग इन द ऑटोमेशन टूल वेयर यू डोंट नीड टू नो द कोड सो हु क्रिएटेड दिस होल डिस्टिंक्शंस और सीजंस और डिविजंस और बाइनरी फ्यूजन्स ऑफ automation, manual, you complicated the story and we sold the story. I will give you two automation engineers outsourcing model stuff. I will give you three performance engineers as if you will have four hands and five legs. I will give you 10 only UX testers as if he has come from EFEX. Sir, I have seen this whole, and from my own house, from my own hands, I have also built. I have done protocol practices, I have also run the PNL, I have also built, I have also done customer meetings, I have made money. I am not saying that I am different from others, but I am telling if I was not doing this, this was the model. Now I am philosophically thinking whether this model is right or wrong, because no one thought for the customer, everyone thought for the company. Okay, DevOps happens with two gears, with two engines, with two speed in bimodal form. A two-speed architecture, enterprise, IT. We talked about the enterprise architecture, where the whole Docker and the container architecture was developed to start the microservices, which you talked about. Then we have the IT architecture. And then we had the IT architecture, which was cloud-based. We know how iCloud containers work. Then we had the testing architecture, which became automated with real users in production environment. So the story started. Case study. This is a little big case study, but I'll try to make it smart, short. This is a company which I always like, and I talk about it in any of the conferences, so I'll continue to talk here on Netflix. How many of you have heard of Netflix? It's a cloud-based IT architecture, a dedicated DevOps team, web images, live, load balancing technology, traffic management, the best, automated monitoring, Netflix can deploy code in its production environment within hours. And I have given you the data how the within hours story happens. You must have seen this data. It's coming late. I put it here. It is not Netflix example, but this is how a new code can go on a production site within an hour. You write the code for the service, microservice. You build it, use Jenkins, any tool. You run it. There is no build master. There is no run master. The no run team, no build team. The run and the build all working under a common umbrella. The run and the build, you know, having a single team. They're developing images, they're testing it for 10 minutes, and then they're deploying in production. At this, it's 1 hour. I mean, it can be exactly 1 hour, but I'm just trying to give an indicative figure that you can manage a business in 1 hour. The IT leaders are telling that I can use DevOps where I can make more sense, where it is simple, fluid, I can use DevOps. If I want to make some changes, if I'm already stable and reliable, I cannot do DevOps. Now the question to all of you, can I use DevOps to launch a satellite? The question for the day. Can I do a space Columbo shuttle Challenger into the orbit? And can I give a DevOps to the NASA team and say, India, we have DevOps, I'll come and develop. How many of you say yes? How many of you say no?
Maybe possible.
We'll build that on a yes.
Maybe possible.
Maybe possible. I'll come to you. On the fence. On the fence. Very smart. It didn't take either side. Maybe possible. Sagar. Sagar.
Yeah.
Sagar. Yes.
I think yeah, that's something to be thought about.
Okay.
Immediately that comes to my mind is no.
Okay, Rama, life sciences, neonatal department.
Virtual launching is possible.
Virtual launching is possible, but not the real launch. You can show DevOps software to your kid and tell that it is a 3D technology. Chasma laga ke dekho DevOps software hai. Huh? Dekho kaisa launch hota hai. But you can tell it to a NASA astronaut. A life science systems, a neonatal center of a premier hospital, can it use DevOps? A mission critical operation of an army baseline camp of a naval quarter, can it use DevOps? This is what I said, DevOps cannot be its context, sandarbh. It is situation sensitive. You cannot use DevOps when and wherever you think you may require. You need to have a balance of usage of DevOps based on the application complexity, project complexity, and application uncertainty. This is very important, and this is what I've been talking. Reliability, where it is more important, resilience, speed to market, DevOps, good case study. I have models where software delivery people are considering that to make platform as a service. Okay, fine still. I have to redefine the roles of people when I do DevOps. I call it as a generalizing specialist, a cross-functional team who knows infrastructure, who knows operation, who knows everything, who is an all-stack engineer. All-stack, full-stack engineer. A tester comes to me and says, sir, I can do testing. I ask him, will you know Java? Java. Do you know any automation? Then automation tool, sir, my automation tool applied in here. Manual tool. He can put the or load something with this one. No. I don't know that. Why should I know? I have been told that this is the assembly line, this is my workstation. I will stand near the workstation, yahan pe wo aadmi mar raha hai, nahi ja sakta hun, kyunki wo mar raha hai uske workstation mein, mere boss ne bola hai, iske andar hi khade ho. My boss has told, your job is this, yahan pe job part kholo, yahan pe job part band karo, bagal wala wahan fire hai, theek hai, uske side jalne do, maybe when it comes here, I will try to go. This is dangerous, this is happening. Application teams, ABM, testing, QA, deployment, performance management, monitoring, virtualization, configuration management. You remember, you will be very surprised, there was a role in IT industry called configuration master. Maine ek baar apply kiya tha when I was young, in nokia.com. Jaake pucha kya, doctor, at that time I didn't do a PhD, didn't say doctor, Shankar, you don't have to do anything, only you have to do that VSS, Visual Source Safe, and the SCCS. But SCCS tool is there, you have to sit there. Algebra was also good. One guy gave me a job, build master, only build making, thinking stuff, which is one part of the game now. So see how nicely we created departments. And by creating departments, we became ignorant of the fact that we should have even learned that. We never had an end-to-end or a seamless approach. Yes, it started like that. One guy was hired and he takes a taxi. Interestingly, 17%. Gandhiji, this is the last and the most important punchline for the day. You all thought it is quality, business excellence, quality, Six Sigma, lean and mean. But here the customer is saying, give me something. It may not be 100% quality, but at 50% quality, I had a great experience. And he says, be part of it. Means the tester becomes a customer advocate. Tester becomes a customer advocate. Tester is writing the test strategy with the customer. So this is a new paradigm shift which has started in the industry. And with these few words, I would like to stop. I think it's time to stop for all disturbance. Thank you very much. And any questions before we fine. I hope you got the message.
Can I take the liberty to say Rafsan is around, so if you have any questions,
right,
we will take it post this, okay?
Okay.
Rafsan, sorry ma'am.
No, it's okay.
I don't feel bad and
I can get into that.
So again, if you look at it, I really am sorry about this. This is basically a poorly managed stuff from my side. And I'm really sorry for that. But again, this session has been really wonderful, Rafsan. Thank you so much. Then all of us who are there, I think the way he connected to the entire
thank you.
Thank you.